Good evening. You're watching Reporters Diary on the Eco of India's digital platforms. And before I move ahead with our team of reporters, let me share with you the major points which are in news today. A day after staking claim for the formation of government, Nitish Kumar was today sworn in the Chief Minister of Bihar for the seventh time. He was administered the oath of office at Raj Bhavan by Governor Fagu Chauhan in presence of top leaders of the NDA, including Union Home Minister Amit Shah and BJP National President Jagat Prakash Nadda. Prime Minister Narendra Modi today urged people to continue to support the local economy and also appealed to the seers to spread the message of vocal for local. The Prime Minister made this appeal at the occasion of unveiling a statue of Jain seer Vijay Vallabh Sureshwar through video conference. Addressing the program through video conference, the Prime Minister said, "The way the country gave a tremendous support to the local economy on Diwali and other festivals, it indeed gives a new energy and we have to maintain this." In a veiled attack on Pakistan, External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar today said one of India's neighbors was indulging in state-sponsored cross-border terrorism. The minister today also said relentless efforts by India helped in keeping the spotlight on cross-border terrorism it faced, and the world was gradually becoming aware of the global nature of international terror. The Central Armed Force, Armed Police Forces, CAPFs, will play a crucial role in distribution of COVID-19 vaccines, according to the DG of Indo-Tibetan Border Police, ITBP, SS Deswal. The ITBP DG also said that the union government's plan for the distribution and use of the vaccine against COVID-19 was ready. Union Health Minister Harshvardhan has already said India is hosting clinical trials for all major vaccines and around 20 of them are in different stages of development. And in the USA, President Donald Trump has accused the mainstream media of taking sides with Democratic candidate Joe Biden and not reflecting on his side of the story. He questioned, why does the fake news media continuously assume that President-elect Joe Biden will ascend to the presidency next January? The mainstream media had declared Biden as the winner of the November 3 presidential election last week, but President Trump has refused to concede the election, asserting that he has won. He has filed several lawsuits alleging electoral fraud. And now I move on with our team of reporters. We are joined by Razia from Port Blair and Riddhi from Kolkata. Yes, Riddhi, you may start. What all you have?
The first news that I would like to share is BJP chief in Bengal, Dilip Ghosh, today asserted that if voted to power in the next assembly polls, his party will emulate Gujarat's growth model to develop the state and slam the successive governments for not doing enough to create jobs. Criticizing the erstwhile left-front government dispensation for alleged politicization of the educational system, he said Bengal, which once produced the finest scientists, doctors and engineers, is now churning out migrant laborers. Ghosh claimed this during a chai pe charcha session at Barashat in North 24 Pargana, said Didimoni, that is Mamata Banerjee, often says that we, BJP, are trying to turn Bengal into Gujarat. I say that we will certainly do so and turn it into a developed state. Our men and women do not have to go there for work. We will ensure employment opportunities available here. Also, Bengalis do not make it the merit list of the competitive exams anymore, he stated. Senior TMC leader and state minister Firhad Hakim, reacting to Ghosh's assertion, said that Trinamool Congress, which has time again trained guns on the BJP's over the 2002 communal strife in the western state, claimed that Gujarat is known for riots and encounters and not for development. It's not the development that we associate Gujarat with. Over 2,000 people were killed, encountered deaths of people like Ishrat Jahan have occurred. If Bengal is turned into Gujarat or UP, then here too people will get killed in encounters. We want our state to remain the way it is. That's all Firhad Hakim said. And now in another development, the air quality in Kolkata turned poorer on Sunday evening from what it was 24 hours ago on the Kali Puja and Diwali day. But it was still better when compared to the recorded day after the festivals last year. An official of the West Bengal Pollution Control Board said this. The air quality index was higher than the Saturday's figure across the city. Though the air quality remained poorer in the North Kolkata, it continued to be moderate elsewhere. Environmentalist S.M. Ghosh said, thanks to the court order, public awareness and activities of the Kolkata police, health experts and NGOs, now the air pollution is less. And so far, as stories from the hills are concerned, for the first time, keeping in mind increasing demand of the people, an Aadhaar Seva Kendra was set up near Meghdoot Cinema Hall of Siliguri town. People from entire North Bengal will be able to get services regarding their Aadhaar card from this center, which will remain open for all 7 days of the week. That's all I have from today.
All right, Sridhi, thank you so much for all the updates that you bring to us. We move on to Port Blair with Razia.
Good evening, Shafi, I would like to start with a tragic accident today. Two boys of Tushnabad resident killed in a road accident today afternoon. The two, according to the information from the police, the two youths of Tushnabad were driving in a reckless speed, and they hit the state transport bus, which was coming from the other side. And on the spot, both the boys are died, and the police is investigating this issue. And the second one is the remote islanders of Camel Bay joined hand together in a protest. They are up in arm against the administration because there is no boat services are provided. And now they are demanding, when all over India the lockdown is over, why the Andaman administration is not providing regular boat services to these to the islanders so that they can move around. So the assistant commissioner visited, and he requested the agitated villagers to stop this agitation. But they said they want everything in a written statement so that they should have the complete assurance that the administration will fulfill their demand, and weekly once to and fro boat services should be provided. And all over India, the islanders also, the last one is the islanders also celebrated the festival of Diwali on September 20, on Saturday. And the islanders had a safe Diwali following the COVID-19 protocol. So for today, that's all from Andaman, Sheffield.
All right. Thank you, Razia. Thanks, Sridhi, for joining Reporters Diary this evening. Viewers, this is all we have in Reporters Diary this evening. Thanks for watching.